15 lives, and I wasn't ever, it was never to make a whole bunch of money. It was never about that. Mm-hmm. So he was the biggest breadwinner. So what happened is, this was 9 years ago, his company downsized, and the nine people that were the soonest hires in the company, didn't matter how, what kind of growth you had or how good you were doing, and he was in charge of a big region, the nine soonest employees, they all lost their job.
Wow.
And, you know, he was early 50s at that point, and he didn't look for another job. And all of a sudden, all of the responsibilities financially were on my shoulders. And
wow.
I was, to say I was angry was a total understatement, but I could not be angry. I had to be a loving supporter because he was devastated at the loss of his job.
Yeah.
And I had to be not only the breadwinner all of a sudden, but I had to support him and nurture him and love and still loving him. I could never say, get a fucking job. Like, I couldn't do that, even though that's what I wanted to do.
Yes.
So what happened is literally, excuse my language there. Maybe that's that can be edited out.
Dory does that too.
I swear quite often.
Okay.
Sorry.
Okay.
You know me.
Okay. Well, I wasn't sure. But what happened is about a month after he lost his job, I started having chronic pain.
Wow.
That took me down.
Is this the one that you have in your knee?
My knee. And then it jumped to my foot.
Yeah.
And then it jumped to my hand. No, it jumped around
as I would recognize
that something, nothing's wrong here, and then nothing's wrong here.
Now, I'm mad at your husband, too, because my wrist has been killing me.
Well, you're going to have to take that up with him. Take that up with him. So this is when I met Steve Ozanich.
Yeah.
Okay? So I met him through a mutual friend. I was kind of limping along, and but I wasn't I'm not a complainer. Mm-hmm. So I just was thinking this. I'm getting older. I'm very, very active. Mm-hmm. And my body is just breaking down because that's what happens as we age. Mm-hmm. And that's because I went everywhere.
Wow.
I even flew to New Jersey. Mm-hmm. I have a customer there. He does this really great technique. And he worked on me for 3 days. Mm-hmm. And I spent like $3,000 on his treatments. And I spent over the probably 4 years before I discovered what was really going on with me and the pain and emotion. Mm-hmm. I spent thousands of dollars on acupuncture, adjustments, you name it, everything.
Which, those things will work if you've
take
care of the underlying issue.
Of course, and I'm not. I love all those things.
Yeah, they're all
so
good.
So I was at an event, and I was kind of hobbling a little bit because I was in pain, but I didn't say anything, and I was living with it really. Mm, yeah. And someone, Joe Polish, said to me, "What's going on with you?" And I had just met him, and it was his event, and I said, oh, just this little knee thing. I had an old water ski accident, and I hurt my knee, and it's now bugging me. And he asked me a few questions, and then he said, well, listen, I have a friend. His name is Steven Ozanich. He wrote a book called The Great Pain Deception, and if you tell him you're my friend, he'll give you a consultation, because he's really hard to get into.
I love him.
So I called Stephen up, and we had an hour consultation, and it was an amazing conversation. My eyes were completely opened.
Wow.
Because he didn't say, how long ago was your water ski accident? I mean, he asked me a couple of these things, but then he's like, what's going on in your life? When the pain started, what did your life look like? Mm. I said, well, it started right after my husband lost his job. Okay. Tell me about that.
Mm.
And how did that make you feel? Mm. Were you angry? I said, I was so angry about that. He goes, but you couldn't tell him you were angry, right? I said, no, I'm a nice person, and I'm a good wife and a loving wife.
Yeah.
And I couldn't.
And you love your husband.
I do.
Yeah.
But
so
I was really,
like, yeah,
it doesn't discount the fact that I was so angry at him.
Yeah.
So he explained to me that what was happening is my body was creating pain, and the pain is real. It's a cutoff of blood flow.
Yeah, it's real.
So it's not saying, oh, it's all in your head. No, it's not all in your head. The pain is absolutely real.
Yeah.
And he said that what is happening is it's protecting you because the emotional pain is so painful that your body is distracting you.
Wow.
And I was like,
light bulbs.
Holy.
Wow.
So he said, well, look, we could talk for a long time, but why don't you buy my book and then let's talk again. So I bought his book, and that's a whole other little story. I didn't read it right away, but he checked in with me and said, hey, how are you doing? And I said, I'm still in pain. He goes, well, have you read my book? I said, no. I said, I have it, though. So I said, I made him a promise, because especially since he reached out to me, I was just like, wow, who does that? I mean,
cool.
He's the most caring person. So I read it, in a week. And this is a big, dense, thick book, as you know,
oh, yeah.
right?
Oh, yeah, I've read it.
So I sat down and I read it. I got my highlighter on. I was just like, oh, my gosh, light bulbs, light bulbs, light
wow.
bulbs, light bulbs.
I need to get this book.
It's so good. And then at the end of the week, I called him up. I said, Stephen, my pain is 90% gone because of reading this book.
Wow.
No, literally. And he said, that's called knowledge therapy.
Oh, I love it.
That's what that is. And he said, it's really rare that people heal so fast because we still want to think our body's broken. Mm. We still want to think we're an exception. Like, oh, no, I really, no, really, my back hurts because I have a bulging disc. Mm-hmm. Well, your disc normally bulges because that's how your spine works. It doesn't, yeah. it bulges, but it doesn't cause you pain. Mm. I mean, when you're a 20-year-old, that's when your discs in your back start to degenerate.
Well, yeah, we're all going to have degenerative disc disease.
From when you're about 20.
Exactly. Mm. I remember having them do something with my back, and they noticed that I had this. Do you have back pain? I'm like, no.
Yeah.
I still don't have back pain. It's rare unless I've been laying around for 6 months.
Is the problem? Well, that's the problem.
Yeah.
So people, they get an X-ray and the doctor goes, there you are, a pinched nerve. If you had a pinched nerve, you would not be able to move.
Yeah, that's true.
You would be paralyzed.
Yeah.
So, but now we have some place to go, see, I'm broken. Mm-hmm. See, my body is broken. And I'm not saying that there aren't situations where our bodies need
truly
to help. And those are not the situations I'm
talking
about.
Well, and
you're
also saying it is real. What they're experiencing is real. You're not saying this is made up in their head.
Right.
That's where I think people need to realize your knee pain was real. Mm-hmm. It was happening. The blood was being cut off. You were having degenerative, whatever was going on in there. Mm-hmm. Inflammation, arthritis, probably all of these things. It was real.
Yeah, yeah.
But the reason for it
was, so here's one of the big, and I still use it to this day because it's been 5 years now since I read that book and talked to Stephen. He's one of my dearest friends.
Okay, say the name of the book again.
So it's called The Great Pain Deception.
Okay, and it's by?
Stephen Ozanich.
Okay, because we want all of you guys to read it if you feel like you need to.
Yeah,
so that's awesome.
Ozanich. And you can just get it on Amazon.
It's a great
book. But basically I have what's called a rage journal. So I have a journal. And when I
awesome.
So this is what, so this is what I do. And I bought a journal that's perforated, so I can, you know, I can tear a page out.
Yeah.
And I can write, and I travel with this. So when I travel, and it's just me and my husband on vacation, there are moments that still come up.
Wow.
Because my relationship isn't perfect. Nobody's relationship is perfect.
No.
And I do have I know what my triggers are. Mm. So I will open my. And my husband knows what I'm doing. He knows it. He does.
He'd much rather you do that, though, I'm sure.
Better
than rip him a new one, right? Or divorce him.
He's like, just a minute. Yeah. Start writing. If we're on vacation and it's just him and I, but normally I go someplace quiet where he doesn't see me.
Honey, you're in the bathroom an awful long time.
Luckily, I have a whole building behind my house I can go.
No kidding.
No, but the thing that I found empowering about this is I let this ego inner child of me come out and just say the most angry, hateful things I would never express. Things because we live in a society where we need to be civil and kind to each other. These things need to come out.
The 3-year-old would say them.
Yes.
And then be done with it.
That's right. But we don't
say it because it's not nice, and then we hold them in.
We do. So if you can literally put these, it's like, think about when you get mad at somebody, a coworker, and you shoot off an angry email. Mm. It makes you feel better just writing the email. But if you didn't hit the send button, you just, let me think on this overnight. Like, hopefully this is something people learn. You only have to do that once to go, I don't need to do that again.
Yeah.
You come back to the next day and you're like, oh, I'm so glad I didn't send this. Delete. Mm-hmm. So when I have these moments, I write it. I don't shred it right away. I will go back to it the very next day, and I'll read it again, and then I'll shred it.
I rip it
out and I shred it.
Wow.
And I'm telling you, it's anytime I feel pain somewhere that I know it's not from an injury, it's not from aging, it's not from my body falling apart, because we're designed, you guys think about this, we're designed to die old and healthy. Mm. We might be slower. We might not be able to water ski and ski and do all the things that we want to do. We might have a little aches and pains here and there, but typically no. Mm. Our bodies, no matter how old we get, especially if we take care of them, right?
Yeah.
Are supposed to give us no pain.
And it would be great to just go to sleep and our heart just says, yeah, I'm just done. I'm going to beat real slow and just
I think
stop.
Everybody wants that,
yeah.
right?
Yeah, we do.
And
yeah.
that, and you're, that's what I hear you saying is we have that capacity to do that.
We do, like, but yeah, it's we're trained by our medical industry to think our body breaks down and hurts us as we age.
Well, and I think so many of us none of it. Seriously hold a lot of that stuff in.
Get
I
a
mean,
rage journal.
We may not be like yellers and screamers. We don't want to hurt other people or whatever it is.
Yeah.
Maybe some of us are and need to write instead.
Yeah, yeah.
But I think that is just an awesome thing, Jane. I love that. I'm getting a perforated journal today.
Well, let me tell you what I did. I went to GoDaddy and bought the domain myragejournal.com.
I hope awesome. So, because I'm like, dude, there's
great.
Like the bullet journal out there. There's all these different journals you could buy that, and people would love to have something that, you know, inspires them to do that, you know.
Yeah.
And it's
yeah.
funny because I started a while ago, I was working with a therapist and she has me, and I have to commit. And so I told her I can at least do this 3 days a week. So I do this at least three days a week. And I can tell you, I usually do it more. But I sit there and I set a timer for 10 minutes and I always go over the 10 minutes and I just start writing. And there's no editing. There's no going back, looking at it. There's no punctuation.
That's
it's just
perfect.
flow. And I go and I write and I write and I write and I write. And then I flip it over and I just keep going and I write over. So I can't go back and read everything. But so I'm kind of actually like yours. But then when I'm done with that and I light a candle when I'm doing it.
That's nice.
So that all of this energy that's going out is getting diffused by the candle also. And then afterwards, I burn it.
Yeah, that's great.
And
yeah.
so, but I like your idea of writing it, and then saving it. And then maybe a day or so after that anger or whatever has dissipated, which it always does. How many times have we been in an uproar about something and 2 or 3 days later, it's like, I don't know, I was so pissed off about
that. Yeah. Let me tell you, then
burn it after.
Well, let me tell you the reason. Because I would shred it right away because I was a little bit embarrassed.
Yeah.
Because
that would be hard.
Because
it
was so ugly.
Yeah.
Like, we don't like to think of those ugly
parts
of us.
I don't want to look at myself that way.
Right.
I don't want to look at my
so
dark.
So let me tell you what this did. I decided, so one day I was so mad and I wrote like 5 pages of just ugliness and then I went to bed and I got up the next morning and I didn't do anything with it. But then later that day I read it. And what it did for me is it validated my feelings. It was like,
wow, we need that too.
Yeah. That's what I mean. It's like, it's okay. It validated that it was, yes, I had those feelings. I don't feel them at that intensity anymore, but it was validation.
Right.
And then I shredded them. So now I always wait.
I love that.
And overnight.
I'm doing that. I'm going to add that to mine.
Mm-hmm.
And I love that because then, you know, like you said, you can get up and you can look at your husband and go, I love him. And you felt like this the day before. I grew up watching people get angry at each other and they split up.
Yeah.
And so this is like huge validation that you can feel that way. You can be mad. You can be angry. You can hate them and they're ugly and they're all these ugly things. And whatever you want to call, I am labeling it horribly, but you know what I mean. And then it's out and you look at him and it's like, I don't really hate them. I love them. I was just mad. And I'm just mad and it's okay.
And I'm still mad at the situation.
Yeah.
Yes.
And that's okay.
And that is okay.
Yeah,
and that's
because,
okay.
And it's okay. So, and I've also, because of this whole thing, have become a better communicator.
Yeah.
So
totally.
I can not only write this, but I can say, honey, look, this is really bothering me. Mm. If I'd had that back then when he lost his job, I'd be like, this is really making me mad.
Yeah.
You need to get a job.
Yeah.
You need, or whatever. So it makes, and now as it's been 9 years now, I can be, here's my feelings about what you're doing or not doing or what I'm,
right.
You know, I am a ridiculous perfectionist. Mm. Like I want my house clean and stuff picked up and he's a lovable slob.
But he's a great cook.
He's amazing. I mean, that's why we're still married. We've been married 20 years. So
that's awesome.
Anyway,
well, as you're talking, I'm thinking, you know, when we get angry and we get angry and we just keep it in, it's gunk. It's like gunk that just compiles. And we continue to get angry about something. We don't let it out. It fills up. We just need to empty that tank. Clean it out
every time
and just make sure we have that clean container.
That's
so that we're
really
not
good.
Just filling and it gets to the top and then something's
that's a good analogy
bad.
Doing it that way. That's
so
really good.
If we can see that we need to just let's just dump, it's time to dump, then I think that will really help. I mean, I think that is I love that, Jane. Yeah. It's great. I'm going to put that into practice in my
life.
What
I like, too, is you don't have to wait until you're angry. Maybe you can...
Right.
Like I said, I do it 3 days a week. I just start writing, and I'm sometimes surprised. I've yet to go...